tell you what, let's set the mood a little bit. Have a little romance while you're prepifying, you know what I mean? Here we go. Whoa. Beautiful. Really, really nice. Well, well, well. Welcome to my castle. Today, we're going to learn how to cook some food. So come on in. Take the two-step walk in. Now you may be asking yourself, first thing you noticed, his kitchen's not that nice. Usually when you see these cooking videos, it's really beautiful with an open and airy kitchen and everything's just so wonderful. And everything couldn't be more positive. This isn't anything like that. This is almost like we're cooking outside. But it'll work. And so the theme for today is, if we can do it in a teeny little galley kitchen that isn't even mine, you can do it anywhere. And you almost certainly your kitchen's nicer than this. So come on in. First thing we're gonna do, we're making chicken and zucchini today. The whole thing is to bulk prepare ingredients that you use a lot of. So one reality is that you need to consume adequate protein regardless of your goals. If you're trying to lose fat, you need to eat enough protein. If you're trying to gain muscle, you need to eat enough protein. That's not our rule. We're not paid by the National Protein Council or whatever. Like, that is the rule. We can't get around that. Now, how you choose to get your protein in is entirely up to you, and there's a zillion different ways to do that. One of the most effective means and a really high quality source is chicken. And a lot of people have different dietary preferences. There's things they don't like to eat, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. That's perfectly fine. Most people eat chicken. So we're gonna do a series of these videos. Sometimes we're gonna cook some red meat too. We're gonna make some steaks. But for today, we're gonna do chicken. We're gonna do it in the easiest possible way. This is like video one, volume one, easiest possible thing. So chicken, roasted in the oven, easy breezy, lemon squeezy, and then we're gonna make zucchini too, but we're gonna start with chicken. So, come on over. We hunted this chicken from the woods. Just kidding. We hunted it from the refrigerated section at Kroger. Really straightforward. So what you're gonna do is, we have our oven preheating. We're gonna set it to 425. Easy breezy, lemon squeezy. While that's preheating, we're going to open the chicken. We're going to plop it on here. Now, you could cut it up beforehand. It's way easier to cut it up after it's already cooked. So what we're going to do is roast the breasts whole on here because it's the easiest way to do it. You can cut them in half. You can do all kind of banana stuff. That's perfectly fine if you want to. I'm going to show you the easiest possible way. So get your hands in there. They won't hurt you. They're dead already. You're just going to fit them on there. Real nice. You don't want to overcrowd the pan, but they can be stacked pretty close. Spent a decent amount of time in restaurant kitchens, and your favorite restaurants, they are packing things onto trays, so you don't need to be super worried about that. So you're going to get them on there. You're going to take this. You're going to throw it away, unless you want to keep it. There you go. Straightforward. You're going to wash your hands. Really good idea. All right, so I washed my hands. Pretty good idea so you don't give yourself food poisoning. We wanna wash your hands pretty frequently throughout this, although that's kind of the last time we're gonna touch raw chicken. It's all here ready to go. Common mistake. People are using chicken as a protein source, or turkey or something like that, something that's pretty inoffensive. And they make the mistake of eating it for every one of their meals every day. That's not a good idea, because even if you really like chicken, you're gonna get real tired of it. So, assuming you're still gonna have it relatively often, maybe for two meals a day, most days of the week, we need to make it taste a little bit different. You certainly could just keep it like this, throw a little salt on there, roast in the oven, and then have it with mustard or whatever after. We do that all the time, that's fine. If you don't really care, that's the easiest way. Just fire it in there and then eat it when it comes out, straightforward. If you want it to be a little spiced up, let's put some stuff on it. What we're gonna do is do chicken two ways. Oh my God, very difficult. First way, We're going to put some of this seasoning on it. We're going to do that on two of the chickens. So we're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Just like that. Really straightforward. Not hard. That's all. Then, the second ones, we're going to put some either red hot or barbecue sauce on. We're going to talk about it off camera while it's cooking and decide. Either way, perfectly good. So those ones, we're going to put that on towards the end of the cooking process. Once you get the spicifies on, she's ready to rock. So we're going to move it over here. Oven's still preheating. While the oven is preheating, we're going to start to cut off these zucchinis. So we're going to get our other pan. We're going to put that right here. We're going to get a cutting board. Real nice, just regular human style cutting board. I'm sure yours are really nice. Mine are just the normal 1,000-year-old dollar at the dollar store jobs. They work real nice. And so we're going to show you two different ways to prepare your squash and zucchini. So these are really easy to eat. They're usually very inexpensive at the store. They're really easy to digest and they're really easy to prepare. So easy, 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 easy. They're also not calorically dense. So if you're on a fat loss diet and you're trying to keep your volume of food up so you're not brutally hungry, really, really, really good idea. So first thing you can do, come on over here, cameraman, is we're just gonna think about cutting the ends off and then we're gonna cut them into medallions. Very, very fancy. Super fancy, you're gonna do that. Set those there. Medallion, medallion, medallion. Now when you get closer to your fingers, notice I have my fingers out like this. Not a good idea, so we don't wanna cut our fingers off. So you're gonna go ahead and roll those fingers back a little bit so we can save those for use at a future time. You're gonna cut them up like that, real nice. Move them over here. Spread them out on the pan. Easy breezy. Notice the pan's a little banged up. We use this pan basically every day. That's the idea. That's why you have pans. Now that's one way you can do it. The other way, if you don't like medallions or just to change it up a little bit, is you cut the top and bottom off so that the squash or zucchini sits upright, and then we're going to cut it into strips. The strips can be as thick or as thin as you'd like. We think about 1/4 inch of thickness is good, and then you're just gonna set those animals just like that. All right, so our oven's preheated. We're about to put everything into the oven. Last thing we're gonna do is throw a little seasoning on these guys. Really good option, especially if you're on a fat loss diet and you're watching your fat. Even if you're on a muscle gain diet and your fat isn't super, super high, is to use a little bit of cooking spray. So we just have the olive oil spray. Now, it says calorie zero. In reality, there are calories in this. So we want to be judicious about how much spray we're using, but just you give it a little shake, a couple little sprays there, never hurt anybody, really nice. And then super easy, again, this is a basic video, so we're not gonna go super bananas or super elaborate, really basic seasoning. We're just gonna do a little pepper. Breezy. And then we're going to do a little bit of salt. If you have the opportunity, it's a good idea to salt something like zucchini or any kind of squash or eggplant ahead of time. You'll notice the salt pulls water out of the vegetable. They have a ton of water in them, which is part of the reason why you can eat so much. But it'll pull some of that water out so they're nice and crisp and they don't get soggy as you roast them. Zucchini and squash take longer than chicken, so we're gonna put this in first. We're gonna set our timer for 42 minutes, anywhere from 40 to 45, depending on how much you like them done. At this point, you walk away. That's it. So the idea of prepping food, especially in bulk, is that it should be very easy. For the most part, it shouldn't be a situation where you need to stand here for 3 hours doing stuff. Like literally set the timer, walk away, go back to whatever you're doing. If you work at home, go back to work, go take a shower, go play with your kids, do whatever. You don't need to stand here. How about a little bit of music, huh? We're prepping. making food, we're making our muscles bigger. All right, so we put our zucchini and squash in about 15 minutes ago. We're at about 30 minutes left on the timer, and obviously we're gonna use one timer for both things. We wanna cook the chicken for about 30 minutes, so we're gonna go ahead and pop these guys into the oven too. Easy breezy, and then at that point, you can just go back to doing whatever you're doing, folding laundry, sleeping, reading books, doing work, playing with your kids, push-ups, whatever you wanna do. It's almost time to spicify things up. So on one set of chickens, we did a little dry spice. This side, the other one, the other three, we're gonna do a little bit of red hot. So what you're gonna do, very easy, put the red hot into something. Coffee mugs work really nice because then you can just throw it in the dishwasher when you're done. You're gonna use an oven mitt so you don't burn your hands off to get the chicken out of the oven. Oh my God, how wonderful already. All right, so what we're gonna do, per Amanda's request, is we're gonna do both sides, because we want it to taste really unbelievably nice. So you're gonna paint it like this, like you're an artist. How are you feeling today? We're feeling like putting a lot on there. One, two, three, like this, really easy. The theme that you'll notice so far with this is that none of this, my friends, is rocket science. It's pretty straightforward. We're just making chickens. We're not saving babies or spreading asphalt. We're just painting some red hot on some chickens. We're gonna take a little fork. We're gonna flip, oh my God. We're gonna flip these savages over so we can get the other side. So every bite is an unbelievable flavor experience. I'm gonna get our paintbrush again. Get some more red hot. Blow it up. Now, this is perfectly fine. Red hot is largely calorie free or nominally caloric. It does have a little bit of salt in it. So if you're in a situation where you need to watch your salt, obviously choose your seasoning accordingly. This would be a situation too if we're in a fat loss diet where we would certainly want to avoid sauces with a lot of added sugar. So regular barbecue sauce would be a horrible idea because it has a boatload of sugar in it, but you can find sugar-free barbecue sauce, and then that therefore would be an excellent option. All right, so we have those animals paintified. That goes in the sink. Glove back on. Back in we go. And at that point, you want to do this with about 5 minutes left in cooking. So we're just going to make sure our timer is about 5 minutes. We're going to let those babies roastify, pull it all out, and go from there. Oh, weird. Food's ready. Let's get this stuff out of the old cooking chamber. Oh my goodness. I can feel myself getting stronger just looking at those chickens. All right, so zucchini slash squash is done, chicken's done. What we're definitely not gonna do is try to cut up the chicken right now because it's right around 10,000 degrees, so you'll burn your hands off. So what you're gonna do, again, sticking with our theme of passive and easy, is just go find something else to do. Go back to whatever else you're doing. Take a shower, go for a walk, do whatever. You can leave it out for an extended period of time and nothing's gonna happen. You definitely wanna give it at least probably like 10, 12, 15 minutes before you start to manipulate it. What we're gonna do, if you wanted, you could just package the chicken like this whole. We're not gonna do that. We're gonna cut it up into real fun cubes so it's easy to weigh out later. Yep, sharpen it up. Cutting up some chicken. Nobody likes a dull knife. Let's do it. All right, little movie magic. This is cooled down so you don't viciously burn yourself when you're doing this. Move your chicken over and we're gonna be like a horrifyingly efficient assembly line. So what we're gonna do, as much as we can, is put one flavor in one container and another flavor in another container. You don't even have to really do that if you want. easy breezy. Cut, cut, turn, cut, 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 grab, dump. Easy breezy. You can mow through a whole bunch of chickens in no time. You get relatively equal, not super exactly the same, but relatively equal, easy to measure pieces. So obviously what we're going to extrapolate out is a situation where your container on the scale, put the scale, turn the scale on, put chicken into the scale, and then you're ready to rock. So obviously we're going to pre-major portion it here, and then we're going to break it down into individual protein servings as we need it. So we're going to go with that in there, real nice like that. And we're going to put these animals in this other one. Same game. Same game with our squash and zucchini. We're not going to eat it right now. What we're going to do is just put it into a container so that we can portion it out into smaller servings later. Again, great idea for if you're on a fat loss diet, because you can eat a whole lot of it. All roasted up. In our next episode, we're going to do these babies on the grill, which is real nice. I'm just going to dump it in there. You don't have to be super gentle or artistic with it. We're just firing it in there for later. No big deal. This would be something else you could put some kind of extra spice on if you want to jazz it up a little bit. We're pretty simple guys, so we don't really care less about that. So salt and pepper works real nice. Put the lid on there, nice and tight. Make sure you're not pinching any zucchinis. And then we have everything ready to go. We're gonna pop it into the fridge, nice and neat and organized. For later. And that's it, easy breezy. The name of the game with prepping food is work smart, not hard. It should not be difficult. If it's difficult for you, unless you have a ton of extra time, which is fantastic, you're not gonna stick to it. So what we wanna do is we wanna set up really good systems that are very easy so that we always have food on hand and we're never caught in a position where we're gonna make a horrible decision, not because we don't care, but because we just don't have the stuff ready to go. So work smart, not hard.